Welcome back to The Breakfast. On this day, 1 year ago, the 19th of October in 2020, there were still hundreds of people gathered at the Lekki toll gate, but not just here in Lagos. There were still protests happening across Nigeria, calling and demanding that the government responds to the requests of millions of Nigerian youths across the country, which was to end the special anti-robbery squad. But not just that, also for police reforms, justice for people who have been affected by the high-handedness of Nigerian security agencies across the country. That eventually, led to certain events on the 20th of October that are really, really shocking and have led, left a really, really sad memory in the last 1 year. This morning, we're speaking with Mr. Adesina Tosin, who's an active citizen and, of course, one of the people voicing out with regards to the NSAS protest. Good morning, Mr. Tosin. Thanks for your time and thanks for joining us.
Yeah, good morning, sir.
I'm going to start with asking, for those who say there's really no need to have these conversations, the government has already put things in place. There is a panel that has been set up that is still ongoing in, certain states across the country. There's no need to be angry anymore. Why are we talking about NSAS once again? I want you to, share your thoughts on what your response would be to that, first of all.
Okay, thank you so much. Let me start by saying thanks for having me this morning. Concerning those say that they are really not a student of history, because if they are students of history, they will know that several events have altered the course of the world, one way or the other, and people keep talking about it. Those that don't want us to talk about it are those that I can describe as those that don't want us to have police reform or to ask questions concerning what happened at the Lekki toll gate on the 28th. Now, let me give you an example. If you look, the June 12th election happens in the year 1993, and the conversation around June 12th has been stabilized from 1993 to date. So much more that President Buhari was had no option than to give late Chief MKO Abiola a posthumous GCFR award. What happened that they were able to sustain the conversation for more than 23 years now? NSAS is a conversation that we're going to sustain for the rest of our life, because what is basically NSAS? NSAS was a demand for an end to the notorious police unit that has been renowned for extortion, for harassment, for killings, and everything. I said, okay, Mr. Pro, okay, federal government, end this unit. Apart from ending this unit, we also have a 5-for-5 demand that we made to the government. One, NSAS. Two, police reform. Three, psychology. They need to do some psychology evaluation of SAS officers. And also, we also demand for justice for victims of police brutality across the country. However, 1 year down the line, we can say nearly none of these things have been done. If you are talking about judicial panel, only Lagos State have done judicial panel. Several states in the country, they've refused to do it. Even Abuja, where we have the president, the judicial panel went on a break for about the past 7 months. They are meant to resume tomorrow, which is like a joke. How will you suspend the panel for almost 7 months, and you are coming back on the day the whole world is mourning the killings of NSAS vendors at the Lekki toll gate? It is highly insensitive. So they've not done anything in that regard. If they've done it, we will not be talking about this today. We'll basically be celebrating today. But they did not do anything. And as I'm talking to you now, police has even gone rogue before then. We see what happened during the Oduduwa National protest. Police kill somebody at Ojota. Every day on YouTube, on Instagram, you see video of police officers extorting. Few days ago, they extorted somebody in Kogi State, less than a week now. These police officers, they've been caught in several actions that, in fact, a report published by Premium Times, or the Cable, if I'm right, shows how RRS officers were busy drinking Paraga all across Lagos, playing Baba Jebu. Nothing has been done. Police stations, they still don't have record of criminals. People still don't have justice. As I'm talking to you now, about a year after NSAS, we still have NSAS protesters that are still awaiting detention, that are still awaiting arraignment. Some are still in detention. Yesterday, one of our campaigners, his name is Eroms. Eroms was just free after 1 year. What was his offense? For protesting. One of our comrades, Imoli Ayo, is still having issues with security agencies. What was his offense? For just, they protested for NSAS. These are the issues we are talking about, and this is why we have to sustain the conversation. We have to sustain the conversation for justice. We have to sustain the conversation for history's sake. We have to sustain the conversation for human rights. And historically, this conversation needs to continue. Every day you see people saying, the Endsars protest was not peaceful. It was a protest of talk. They want to remove the president. And I said, no. Endsars protesters, we have no business with President Buhari, and I'm saying it on air. We don't want to remove the president. The president is elected, and he has a tenure of 4 years. We are not interested in the president position. What we want the president to do is to reform the police, give them good jobs, give them salaries, give them materials to work, also stop them from killing us. You are a journalist. A lot of journalists have been killed by police in this country. You can just a simple Google search, you will see the number of journalists killed by police. Open your newspaper, journalists have been killed by police. Even police officers have been killed by police. So this brutality has spread across. Now, if you say we should not talk about it, then those people saying that, they are our oppressors. People are still saying it today. Oh, nobody died at the toll gate. Nobody was shot at the toll gate. Meanwhile, we have seen videos. We have seen pictures. I have met people that were shot at the toll gate that still need extra surgery as of this morning. I have seen people that were shot at the toll gate that their family members are still looking for their dead bodies. So what are we talking about? The Nigerian military, they denied this. They later said that we shot into the head. How will you shot at people that were protesting, singing national anthem, raising Nigerian flag? That is an injustice, and we will continue to talk about this for the rest of our life. And I said something. June 12th, that happened in 1993, they sustained the conversation. The people in power need to know that we are going to sustain this conversation for the sake of progress and for the unity of this country. We have to sustain this conversation.
Okay. So the question is, how do you intend to sustain this conversation? Like you have rightly mentioned, how do you intend to go about it? And at the end of the day, what is the end result? What do you hope to achieve?
Well, two questions. You've asked me two questions. One, we are going to sustain this conversation by the power of the media and by the power of the social media. For the past 19 days now, I've been hosting a series on Twitter called Endsars 20 Days of Activism. And what we've been doing there, we've been talking about Nigeria, about human rights, about police reform, about the law, about national security. We've had several speakers like Aisha Yusufu, Prof. Chidiol Dikalu, Hamza Lawa, David Ondeyi, a lot of people. Tonight, we are going to host Professor Kingsley Moghalu on that same panel. And tomorrow, we are going to host Komedomo Yeleshowore. We are having this conversation because we have to keep talking about that incident. We have to ask ourselves, okay, what did we do right? What did we do wrong? How can we do this thing better? How can we prevent that Nigerians do not die by police again? Now, what is the end goal? The end goal is to have a police that works for all. The end goal is to have a country that works for all. The end goal is to make sure that no Nigerian is killed by police. I'm already saying this on our panel, that every Nigerian is a victim of police brutality waiting to happen. They might not have shot you today. You don't know what's going to happen in the next 2 minutes. We've seen where people are just going home. They are driving. Police stop them. Let me see your paper. No. Okay, this is my paper. Next thing, I will shoot you. And nothing will happen. Police have been saying that. We want to have a police force that has humanity. You will not tell me that you will kill me. And not kill. Some of us cannot even kill chicken. So I can't imagine that a human being will be so bold to say, I will kill you and nothing will happen. The end goal is that there must be an end to police brutality. They will tell you, there is no more sex. However, we still have these same issues happening. EFCC has been raiding people's houses mindlessly for months now. EFCC goes to hotel, they go to people's house. These are the same problems we have with SARS. We cannot live in a country that is having this type of issue. Somebody was on my spaces just the other day and told us how Botswana police imagine the best in Africa. Botswana is even a landlocked country. This is a country not up to Nigeria. Every time Nigerian police, you see that you see them on you see their video on Instagram extorting people, beating people. At times police will be chasing Okada riders. At times police will be doing the things they are not meant to do. The end goal is to have a police that work and a nation that work.
Ms. Adesina, I think you've basically explained all of it, you know, and how you know this affects everyone. I think, you know, one other thing that is important, you know, is really asking whether SARS really has ended, you know, and of course the police brutality that was the major part of the conversation, not just the special anti-robbery squad now, whether that has ended, you know, and of course from the things that we've seen, not very much has changed. But I want you to also speak on the response from the Nigerian government. In the last couple of days, we've seen also that there is a police presence at the Lekki toll gate. riot, police presence at the Dakitogi. And of course, Fowls, the artist, made some statements on his Instagram page, sharing that, they made requests to use the Landmark Center or certain places to gather and have conversations concerning the NSAS protests, and that was also not allowed. So quickly share with us what exactly has gone on, from the response from the government.
Okay, well, from the response of the government, what we've seen is that the government is not even interested in solving this problem. And I'll give you some instances. So, October 20th of every year, nobody can erase that date. And I'm saying it. October 20th will continue to mark NSAS, whether you want to protest or you want to go and lay flowers at the Lekki Toll Gate. The Lekki Toll Gate, it is a symbol of our struggle. And I'm saying it, it can take time. That toll gate, and then we come to that toll gate one day, because it is a monument that must be, that has been erected in honor of our comrade. Now, if people say they want to protest tomorrow, for God's sake, there is nothing wrong in protest. The only thing we have issue with is a violent protest. And if we say we want to go and do candle night at the toll gate, God police should allow us to do it. Lagos Constitutional of Police have said that, nobody should protest, nobody should do this. Let me say this. Whether we protest or we don't protest, NSAS is an idea whose time has come. Let me give you an example. The federal government went ahead to ban Twitter. The banning of Twitter is an aftermath of this NSAS, because they feel like, this is where we should be. But guess what? We are still using our Twitter till this morning. We are still using our Twitter. We are using our hard-earned money. We are paying as much as $10. To subscribe for VPN, because of what the power we have is our power of determination, is our power to protest, is our power to demand for good governance that was not given to us by anybody and cannot be taken away from us by anybody. We have no problem with Governor Sanwo-Olu. We have no problem with President Buhari. We only have problem with killer policemen and people in government that are aiding these killer policemen. Now, apart from SARS, we all know that police brutality is actually, in fact, they've increased since we had the protest. And what we are saying is very simple. The response of the government has not been encouraging thus far. Now, Lagos State, they might say that, we have a panel. The only thing that tells you that we have a panel, we are giving people money. However, is money justice? Money is not justice, my brother. If I was killed at the Lekki Toll Gate on the 20th last year, if you give my family 10 million, 10 million will not bring me back. My family prefer to keep seeing me every day, even if I'm not a millionaire. They just want to know that their son is alive. Now, government, they made several denials. As I'm still talking, I said it earlier, I'm still saying it. Some people are still in detention for NSAS. So if government really wants to say that, they have met their demand, what are people still doing in detention? And this is not only Lagos State. Oyo State, people are in detention in Oyo State, Ekiti State, and a lot of other states in this country for protesting. There is a database of NSAS protesters that has even been released. Why are these people in detention? Some of our comrades, they are still living under fear. Youth left Nigeria to go and get asylum in other countries of the world because of what? Because the government and the agents, they are threatening them. So what can we say about their response? It has been poor thus far, and that's why we continue to talk about NSAS. We will continue to talk about it because it's a conversation. Everybody will leave power one day, but we, the people, we will remain. But thus far, the response of the government has not been encouraged. How we even have it in your mind that people should not even protest? As a government that won't even want to win our hearts, it should even be Governor Sanwo-Olu that will say, okay, no problem. We want to have a problem. I will be the one to lead the work in memorial of NSAS protesters. No leader can. People, that is the way leader actually does to their citizens. You win their hearts back, but they are busy organizing concerts all around. Is it concert that you want? October is a month of mourning for us. We are not celebrating. I don't care what they do. We are not celebrating. We are mourning. We lost people.
All right.
We can't see their dead body.
All right, Mr. Thompson.
Yes.
Just quickly, as much as we know that protest is a tool that has been used by a lot of persons, citizens in democratic dispensation to, get government to respond to their needs and their demands, some quarters are saying that there are other means of engaging. Yes, it's a right, but how about dialogue? How about having these conversations? How about writing petitions? So I'd like to find out if in the nearest future, or is also part, of the plan, because yes, there's been several protests and you are also part of this particular movement, it doesn't seem like anything has happened. The real deal is to get, you know, achieve results. So are you thinking about other, you know, means of getting government, you know, to respond to some of these concerns that you have?
Okay, well, so the issue there is this. And I said this on one of my spaces, even if any of you guys have monitored it. We had a session with Seoni Gbede, and we had a topic called End SARS Activism Beyond Protest. We have mapped out ways you can sustain this conversation without protest. That's why we're having conversations like this on your TV, and the one we are doing on Twitter, and the one we are still going to do on Twitter. We have government. See, let me tell you something about government is this. Government agents, they are everywhere. They know what the street is saying. They are watching this interview at the moment. They know what we are demanding. So we don't even need to protest before you fix what we are demanding. We are saying that, okay, stop your people from killing us. We are not going to protest again. But other ways we can organize. Now, if we say, now, we want to do a forum at Landmark Event Center. That forum was shut down by the government. Landmark Event Center, that they even announced the date, everything, they went to shut it down. Now, how do you want to engage a government like that? Does not allow to do some of these things. It shows that the government is not interested in hearing us. And let me tell you this, the only way that the government can hear us is through protest. We want to have a summit. The only official was invited. A lot of senior lawyers were invited, including the NBA president, Mr. Olusola Akpata.
What happened? Olumide Akpata.
Olumide Akpata, thank you. They went ahead to shut down the... And I'm still saying this. See, NSAS is an idea whose time has come. And let me tell you one thing about life. Any idea whose time has come, you cannot shut it down. Oh. That is why Twitter too is an idea whose time has come. That even the Twitter ban cannot save the government from us having a conversation.
We are having
people in thousands were coming. So if you say that we find other ways to address the government, we have taken steps, but government have still thwarted this step. Okay, let us have a summit. You don't allow us to have a summit. Let us have a walk. You don't allow us to have a walk. Let us have conversation on Twitter. You have banned Twitter.
All right, Mr. Adishinal, Mr. Adishinal, quickly, I think this will be the final question. I want you to share what happens on the 20th, because I've seen the Sorosoke Summit, and that's also our social media handles. It says here, 5 for 5 demands, what's unfulfilled? There's going to be Aisha Yusufu, Fowles, who will be speaking, Ms. Olumide Akpata. There's also Debo Macaroni, Olu Phillips, SAN, Femi Falano, also a couple of other people. So is this still going on online on the 20th? And what happens?
So to start it, I'm not part of the organizer, but anything that is being done in support of NSAS as my support. The organizers have said they will continue the conversation online, and that's what I'm saying.
And what happens after? What happens after the 20th? Is there going to be continuous, online conversations?
By God's grace, after the 20th, there will be conversations. And I'm saying this: we are not going to just stop the conversation about 10 stars. For everybody that wants to contest in 2023, they must be ready to answer that question. What are you going to do to save us from police brutality? Okay, you want to be the president. Whether it's this article that is contesting, or Ashiwaju, or Professor Shibaju, or Professor Mogalu, anybody contesting 2020, we need to ask them that question. What will Nigerian be under you? Will Nigerian youth be killed by the police? And I'm still saying this. Police brutality is not the case of Nigerian youth. Police have killed people in their 50s, in their 80s, in their 70s. And as a country, we have to demand an end to police brutality wherever we are. So even if we are done with October 20, we'll still continue the conversation in the aspect of governance, human rights, law, national security. This will continue. And by tomorrow, October 20, Sorosoke Summit will be holding online. We too will be having our hands-on discourse. It will be happening on Twitter space. So tomorrow is actually a very busy day for us. And some of our comrades are still insisting they want to go and have a peaceful walk at the toll gate. Yes, everything that wants to be done in support, in commemorating the 1 year anniversary of the NSAS and NSAS protest should be supported by the government. And I'm saying it last, this is my last word. NSAS is not a protest against President Buhari. NSAS is not a protest against Governor Sanwo-Olu. We believe in democracy. We believe in Nigeria. We believe in Lagos State. And we want the peace for Lagos and peace for Nigeria. However, what we are saying is that bring an end to police brutality. Let police stop killing us. The police that are killing us today, that we are demanding an end to their brutality, they might end up even killing their own folks tomorrow. Nobody is safe in an environment that is dominated by police brutality. We believe so much in Lagos. We believe in Nigeria, and we believe in democracy. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your time and for having this conversation with us. Of course, I would look out for what happens tomorrow and, of course, also online and get to also hopefully speak with you again. Thanks very much and
happy public holidays. Thank you.
All right. And that's where we will be wrapping up the conversation this morning. Pretty interesting. I totally enjoyed speaking with Tosin there. We, of course, would be leaving. We'll be back here again tomorrow morning. If you missed out on any of these conversations or you would like to catch up, it's simply at Plus TV Africa on Facebook and Instagram. Same to YouTube channel at Plus TV Africa and Plus TV Africa Lifestyle. I am Osao Gie Ogbawa. See you tomorrow.
And I am Mercy Bopo. Do have a happy holiday.